गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ लेक्चर थर्ड. द टॉपिक इज ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. द रिमेनिंग टॉपिक ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. इन लेक्चर थ्री पार्ट वन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, व्हाट ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इज, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, दैट इज ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन प्लांट, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एनिमल्स, देर इज ब्लड सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम, लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑफ ब्लड, प्लाज्मा एंड ऑल अबाउट. सो इन दिस सेशन we will particularly study what about a human transportation system. About human transportation system, we will know different types of blood vessels, their function, their differences. Clear? So the topic will, this transportation topic will complete in this lecture. So let's begin. Now coming about blood vessels, we have talked that blood vessels, in transportation animals, there are two that can be classified as, transportation in animals can be classified as, there is blood one is blood circulatory system and the another one is lymphatic system. So in blood circulatory system there are three parts. One is blood, number two blood vessels, and number three was heart. So the topic blood already discussed in the previous lecture, that is third lecture part one. In this session we will discuss about blood vessels. So what are vessels? Vessels are like pipe. Vessels are like setup, system of pipes in our body. Vessels are like system of pipes in our body. These are systems of pipes in our body. Clear? So blood vessels, there are three types of blood vessels. There are three types of blood vessels. One is artery, number two is veins, and number three, capillaries. Clear? Number one, arteries. Number two, veins. Number three, capillaries. Now, what are arteries? What are arteries? Now, first we should know, arteries carry always oxygen-rich blood. Artery carries always oxygen-rich blood. That means, these are the vessels, that is, arteries are the vessels, always carry oxygen rich blood. Oxygen rich blood means pure blood, or we can say oxygenated blood. Clear? Arteries always carry oxygenated blood, pure blood, or oxygen rich blood. Clear? Veins. Veins always carry carbon dioxide rich blood, which is also known as impure blood or deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood. Clear? So veins always carry carbon dioxide rich blood or impure blood or deoxygenated blood. Clear? So these are the basic things about arteries and veins. If we talk about definition of arteries or veins, we talk about definition of arteries and veins. So what is artery? Now arteries are the blood vessels. Arteries are the blood vessels which carry blood from heart to various organs. Listen carefully. Arteries are the vessels which carry blood from heart to various organs. Clear? So these are the blood vessels. These are the vessels which carry blood from heart to various organs of our body. Clear? These are the vessels which carry blood from heart to various organs. Why? Because oxygen-rich blood first comes at lungs, then lungs purifies the blood and then gives back to heart. Because fresh blood or oxygen-rich blood comes at lungs at first, then lungs purify it, then it sends blood to heart and then it pumps the blood to our different organs. That's why the blood is pure blood. द ब्लड इज प्योर ब्लड और फ्रेश ब्लड. क्लियर? सो दिस इज आर्टरीज. नेक्स्ट व्हाट अबाउट वेन्स? व्हाट अबाउट वेन्स? दीज आर द वेसल्स. दीज आर द वेसल्स विच कैरी ब्लड. These are the vessels which carry blood from different organs of our body to heart. What are the functions of veins? The functions of veins are, these are the vessels which carry blood from different organs or different parts of our body to heart. Clear? The type of blood is, the type of blood veins carry is deoxygenated blood, that is carbon dioxide rich blood or impure blood. Clear? So the impure blood collected by veins from different body parts and it sends those blood back to heart. Clear? Then heart send those blood to lungs, lungs purifies those blood and then sends it back to heart. And then what the heart will do? Heart will pump those pure blood from to different organs of the body through arteries. Clear? So the functions of arteries and veins are just opposite. Clear? Now one question is that oxygen rich blood or pure blood enters through arteries and emits as carbon dioxide rich blood. Listen carefully. Oxygen rich blood, that is pure blood, enters the organ through artery and emits as carbon dioxide rich blood or impure blood through veins. Clear? So if we see diagrammatically, suppose this is organ. Now, oxygen-rich blood or pure blood enters the organ through arteries, and when it emits the organ, it emits through veins, and the blood will carbon dioxide-rich blood. Now, one question is how this conversion takes place, because when blood enters the organ through arteries, it is oxygen rich blood, that means it's pure blood, but when it emits from the organ, the blood becomes impure. How did this happen? This happened because due to respiration. This happens due to respiration. So you have already know what is respiration. In lecture 1 or lecture 2 I have already discussed the process respiration. Now what happened is that when oxygen rich blood enters the organ, organ will utilize this oxygen to produce food and to produce energy. As a result, carbon dioxide will produce. This carbon dioxide will back to the organ. This carbon dioxide rich blood will back to the organ. Clear? And this carbon dioxide rich blood enters the organ as impure blood. Listen carefully. When oxygen rich blood enters the organ through artery, organs will use this oxygen to produce food or to break or to produce food or to produce energy. As a result, carbon dioxide will generate. This carbon dioxide will then back to the organ. Carbon dioxide will then back to the organ. And this carbon dioxide rich blood mixes with the blood and it emits from the organ as a impure blood. Clear? So arteries, what are the function of arteries? The function of arteries is to carry oxygen rich blood or pure blood. Oxygen rich blood or pure blood, that is blood which enters the organ, it enters through artery, and when the blood emits from the organ, it emits as carbon dioxide rich blood or impure blood. Clear? So this the process is respiration. The process is respiration because organ will utilize the oxygen to produce food and to produce energy, which is the mainly respiration. So this conversion takes place due to respiration. Clear? Now number three, capillaries. What are capillaries? What are capillaries? Because capillaries are also vessels, but capillaries are the smallest blood vessels. Among arteries, veins and capillaries, capillaries are the smallest blood vessels. Clear? So these are the smallest blood vessels and have single thick wall. These are the smallest blood vessels and have single thick wall. So we have already learned that oxygen rich blood enters organ through artery and emits from the organ through vein as impure blood or carbon dioxide rich blood. Now the exchange of these gases, the exchange of these gases, that is oxygen and CO2, or more precisely the exchange of this blood, that is oxygen rich blood and deoxygenated blood, the exchange of these two blood takes place where? The exchange of these two blood, that is pure blood and impure blood, the exchange takes place at capillaries. The exchange takes place at capillaries. So capillaries are termed as exchange sites. Therefore capillaries are termed as exchange sites, because the exchange of blood, that is exchange of pure blood and exchange of impure blood, exchange of pure blood and impure blood, the exchange takes place at capillaries. Therefore they are termed as exchange sites. Clear? Because blood enters through artery in organs and emits from the organ through veins. Now somewhere in our body this exchange takes place. Impure blood and pure blood, this exchange takes place somewhere in our body. So the exchange takes place at capillaries. These are the smallest blood vessels. That's why capillaries are called as exchange sites. So the function of capillary, what is the function of capillary? The function of capillary is to exchange the blood. Clear? So we have already told the what are arteries, their function, veins, their function, and capillaries and their function. Now what are the major differences between these three? What are the major differences among these three, between arteries, veins and capillaries? Major differences between these vessels. So we will learn major differences between these vessels. Vessels means arteries, veins and capillaries. So these are features. Suppose the column is features, next this is arteries, veins and capillaries. This is very important. This differences is very important because many times this question came, these differences, these major differences between the vessels, that is arteries, veins and capillaries. Clear? Now first feature is direction of blood flow. Direction of blood flow. So we know in artery, blood flows from heart to different part of the body. So carry blood from heart to different organs or parts of the body. Carry blood from heart to different parts or different organs of the body. And the veins, the function of veins is just the reverse of artery, that is it carry blood from different organs of the body back to heart. So we will write carry blood from different organs to heart. Carry blood from different organs to heart. Clear? The function of capillary is it exchanges the pure blood and impure blood. So it carry it the main function of capillary is to exchange the blood, that is pure blood and impure blood. Or we can say that what about the direction of flow in capillary? Now it carry blood from arterioles to venules. Carry blood, besides exchanging, this is also the difference between artery, veins and capillaries, because we will differentiate according to this feature, direction of blood flow. So capillaries carry blood from arterioles to venules. Clear? So it carry blood from arterioles to venules. Clear? So this is a direction of blood flow. Next, number 2, kind of blood. Feature is kind of blood. So artery carry oxygenated blood or pure blood or oxygen rich blood, but there is one exception. Artery generally carry oxygenated blood or pure blood or oxygen rich blood, except pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery only carries deoxygenated blood, that is impure blood. So there is one exception. So we will write carry oxygenated blood except pulmonary artery. Clear? Except in pulmonary artery. Next, in case of vein always carry deoxygenated blood or impure blood, but there is also one exception. Exception is pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein carries oxygenated blood or oxygen rich blood or pure blood. Clear? So both case there is one exception. So carry deoxygenated blood except in pulmonary vein. Now function of capillaries, it exchanges oxygenated to deoxygenated blood changes from oxygenated to deoxygenated. Clear? Next, differences 3. Pressure. What is the pressure? Because artery, veins, capillaries, both are vessels. Vessel means water pipes. That means there should be pressure among arteries, veins and capillaries. So pressure, in case of artery, pressure is high in artery. So 3, pressure is high. Pressure is high because arteries carry oxygen rich blood. Therefore oxygen rich blood will flow from heart to different body parts. That means pressure should be high because fresh blood or oxygen rich blood flows oxygen, because pure blood or oxygen rich blood or oxygenated rich blood flows from heart to different body parts. That means the pressure should be high because the blood is pure blood. Pure blood is to be reached to different body part from heart. Clear? So the pressure should be high. In case of veins, the pressure is low. Why? Because in case of vein, blood flows from different body parts to heart. That means impure blood is to be flowed from different body part to heart. That means the pressure is low. In case of capillary, here also the pressure is extremely low because the function of capillary is to exchange blood from oxygenated to deoxygenated. That means it only exchanges. There is no flow. It only exchanges. That is, pressure is very extremely low or very low. Clear? Now, differences number four. Differences number four is we can write as blood flow. We can write as blood flow. We can write as blood flow. So blood flows rapidly as the pressure is high. That means pressure is high. That means blood flows rapidly. Blood flows rapidly. Clear? So we will write blood flows rapidly. In case of veins, blood smoothly flows. Clear? Blood smoothly flows. In case of artery, blood flows rapidly with jerks. With jerks. But in case of veins, blood flows smoothly without any jerk. Without jerks. Clear? So in case of artery, blood flows rapidly with jerks. And in case of veins, blood flows smoothly without jerks. In case of capillaries, in case of capillary, it extremely is very small. The blood flow is very small. Clear? Blood flow is very small. Blood flow is very small. Next, if we talk about valves, valve is absent in case of artery, and in case of vein, valve is present. In case of capillary, valve is also absent. Clear? So valve is present only in case of veins, and in case of artery and capillaries, valve is absent. Now what is valve? Now valve is something like tool which prevent the backflow of blood. Clear? Valve is like a tool which prevent the backflow of blood. Clear? Suppose the blood flows from A to B. Clear? Suppose the blood flows from A to B. So the suppose here is a valve present between A and B. So what is the function of valve? The function of valve is to prevent flow from back. That means blood will not flow from A to B. The function of valve is to prevent the backflow of blood. Clear? So these are the differences. Differences also there. I'll just erase the upper part. Also difference is there. Suppose the feature number six differences. Suppose lumen. What is lumen? Lumen is nothing. It is the radius. It is the radius. Clear? Because we are studying about vessels. So vessel means water pipes. They are like water pipes. So there should be radius. So lumen is the radius of the cross section. Clear? So in case of artery, lumen is very narrow because the pressure is high. We have already studied that the pressure is high in this artery. So pressure will be high when the cross section is narrow. If the cross section is narrow, only then the pressure could be high. Clear? So in case of artery, this cross section, that is lumen means radius, this is narrow. In case of vein, the lumen is wide. Why? Because in case of vein, the pressure is low. So pressure is low means this cross section is very wide. That's why pressure is low. In case of capillary, it is very small. It is very small. The lumen is or radius is very small. So these are the differences between the vessels, that is arteries, veins and capillaries. Clear?
नेक्स्ट द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक और वी कैन से द लास्ट टॉपिक इज ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. द लास्ट टॉपिक द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज ब्लड सर्कुलेशन. हाउ ब्लड सर्कुलेट्स इन आवर बॉडी. ब्लड सर्कुलेशन इन द बॉडी मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक. Now, to understand blood circulation in the body, we will understand this topic through a diagram. We will understand this topic through a diagram because this is the most important topic and a little bit complicated. But we will understand this topic with the help of a diagram. Suppose this is the lungs. I'll just make the diagram and then I will show this how blood circulate in our body. Suppose this is the lungs and this is the heart. So in heart there are all total four chambers. Heart is divided all total four chambers. Clear? All total four chambers. This is our heart. Suppose this is our heart. Clear? So heart is divided by four chambers. This known as right part. Left side is right part and the right side is left part. So this is right atrium. This is your left atrium, right ventricle, and this is left ventricle. So right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium and left ventricle. So heart is total composed of four chambers. The upper two chambers, these are the upper two chambers known as atrium, and these are the lower two chambers, these are known as ventricle. Clear? So upper two chambers are known as atrium and lower two chambers are known as ventricle. So there is two atrium, right atrium, left atrium, and two ventricle, right ventricle and left ventricle. Clear? Suppose this is our body. Clear? Now from lungs the blood enters through heart in left atrium or left atrium. Now left atrium, it flows through left ventricle. From left ventricle the blood enters in our body. Clear? And from body the blood goes to right atrium. Again from right atrium it enters through right ventricle, and from right ventricle it directly goes to the lungs. So this is the pathway. Clear? Now fresh blood means oxygen rich blood or pure blood flows from the lungs. Now blood first comes lungs. Blood first comes at lungs. Lungs then purify this blood and sends to heart. Heart then pumps those blood to different body parts. This in this cycle the blood circulates in our body. So fresh blood flows from lungs. Fresh blood means oxygen rich blood. It flows from lungs, and from lungs the fresh blood enters through this pathway and enters into heart. The fresh blood from the lungs enters in heart through this pathway. From where? The blood enters in heart at left atrium or left atrium. So this pathway, the pathway or the vessels by which the fresh blood flows from lungs to left atrium of heart. This pathway is known as pulmonary vein. This pathway is known as pulmonary vein. It carries oxygen rich blood, because we know that vein carries deoxygenated blood. But in case of pulmonary vein, there is only one exception. We have studied the differences when I told you about the differences among arteries, veins and capillaries. I have already told that veins generally carries deoxygenated blood or impure blood, but there is only one exception, that is pulmonary vein, which carries oxygen rich blood. So the fresh blood flows from lungs to heart at left atrium through a pathway. This pathway is known as, or the vein is known as, pulmonary vein, which carries generally oxygen rich blood. Clear? Now from left atrium, the fresh blood will enter into left ventricle. Clear? Here a valve is present. Here a valve is present between left atrium and left ventricle. The fresh blood enters left ventricle from left atrium. Between this left atrium and left ventricle, a valve is present. The valve is known as bicuspid valve. Valve is known as bicuspid valve. Valve is known as bicuspid valve. We know the function of valve. What is the function of valve? Its function is to prevent backflow of the blood. It is a tool which prevents the blood from backflow. It prevents the backflow of the blood. Clear? So blood finally, the fresh blood finally enters into left ventricle from left atrium. Clear? From left ventricle, the fresh blood then comes to our body. Body means our different organs. Clear? The fresh blood enters into our body, that means enters in our organs from left ventricle. Through which path? The path is known as aorta. The path is known as aorta, or the vessel is known as aorta. It generally carries oxygen rich blood. So the vessel, or the path, precisely known as vessels, the vessels by which fresh blood enters into our body from left ventricle, the vessel will be known as aorta. Aorta carries oxygen rich blood. Clear? Aorta is the largest artery. The question is important. Aorta is an artery. It is the largest artery in human. Clear? So the fresh blood, that is oxygen rich blood, finally enters in our body. That means it enters in organs. Now what the organs will do? The organs will utilizes oxygen from the oxygen rich blood. The organs will utilize this oxygen, and respiration will start. That means the oxygen utilized, the oxygen that organs take, the organs will take this oxygen, or oxygen will be utilized to use or to produce food and to break food to produce energy. Clear? The function of organ is to utilize the oxygen. The function of the organ is to utilize the oxygen or to produce food or to produce energy. In this case, CO2 will generate, there is carbon dioxide will generate. Clear? Now this CO2 will be back to organs. The CO2 will be back to organs and mixes with the blood. That means the blood will now deoxygenated blood, that is impure blood. This impure blood flows from the body. This impure blood flows from the body, and it flows from body to directly right atrium. So the CO2 rich blood or deoxygenated rich blood flows from the body to right atrium. Clear? So this is CO2 rich blood. So the fresh blood comes in body through this pathway, and the body or organ will utilize the oxygen and produce food. So CO2 will generate. Now CO2 will mixes with the blood, and the body emits this deoxygenated blood. Clear? Through this pathway, and it reaches to right atrium. This CO2 rich blood will reaches to right atrium. So this path, that is the vessel by which CO2 rich blood or deoxygenated rich blood flows from body to right atrium, this path or this vessel is known as vena cava. This vessel is known as vena cava. It is a vein. Clear? it is one type of vein. Clear? So the carbon dioxide rich blood or deoxygenated blood or impure blood flows from body to right atrium through vessels. The vessel is known as vena cava. Now the impure blood is in right atrium, the impure blood is in right atrium. So from right atrium, the impure blood or carbon dioxide rich blood enters through right ventricle. From right atrium, the carbon dioxide rich blood or impure blood will goes to right ventricle, but here also a valve is present. Here also a valve is present between right atrium and right ventricle. Here also a valve is present. This valve is known as tricuspid valve. This valve is known as tricuspid valve. So a valve in between right atrium and right ventricle. The valve is known as tricuspid valve. Clear? So the carbon dioxide rich blood will enter to right ventricle from right atrium through tricuspid valve. So the carbon dioxide rich blood finally from right ventricle goes back to these pathways to lungs. The carbon dioxide rich blood will flows from right ventricle through these pathways directly to lungs. So this pathway or this vessel is known as pulmonary artery. This vessel is known as pulmonary artery, which carries carbon dioxide rich blood. Artery generally carries oxygen rich blood or pure blood, but there is only one exception. I have told you in differences, just remember, recall those differences. Artery generally carries oxygen rich blood, but there is one exception, which is pulmonary artery. It carries carbon dioxide rich blood. So pulmonary artery carries carbon dioxide rich blood or deoxygenated blood. The deoxygenated blood from right ventricle will flows from right ventricle and directly into the lungs. So the lungs now contains carbon dioxide rich blood. Now what is the function of lungs? Lungs will now purify this blood and sends it to heart. Then heart, what will heart do? The heart will then pumps those blood into different organs, and the process will continue. The process will continue. I am repeating again this. At first, fresh blood flows from lungs. At first, fresh blood or pure blood flows from lungs to heart. That means in left atrium, through a pathway or through a vessel which is known as pulmonary vein, it carries oxygen rich blood. From left atrium, the fresh blood enters to left ventricle through a valve which is known as bicuspid valve. From left ventricle, the fresh blood will enter to our body through a vessel which is known as aorta. It also carries oxygen rich blood. Now the fresh blood is in our body. That means particularly or more precisely in our organs. Now what the organs will do? Organ will utilize the oxygen to produce food or to produce energy. In this process, CO2 will generate and the carbon dioxide will mixes the blood, and the blood becomes impure or deoxygenated. This impure blood will emitted by the body and flows through the right atrium through vena cava. Clear? This carbon dioxide rich blood or impure blood will flows from the body to right atrium. It enters again in the heart in right atrium through a pathway or through a vessel which is known as vena cava. It is a vein. From right atrium, the carbon dioxide rich blood or impure blood will enter to right ventricle through a valve which is known as tricuspid valve. From right ventricle, finally this carbon dioxide rich blood or impure blood will directly goes to the lungs through a vessel which is known as pulmonary artery. Clear? Now the lungs will have carbon dioxide rich blood. So lungs will now pure this blood and sends to heart. Then heart will pump those pure blood to different our body parts, and the process, this total cycle will continue. Clear? So this is the blood circulation in our body. In this way, blood circulates in our body. Clear? Now one question frequently asked in exam, that what is double circulation? This question is very important. What is double circulation? What is double circulation? Now if you clearly understand the diagram, you can easily see that when blood passes through heart, blood generally passes two times. Blood passes two times in a heart. When at first blood, fresh blood flows from lungs and enters into the heart at left atrium. Then the fresh blood from left atrium enters through left ventricle. Clear? Then from left ventricle, the fresh blood enters the body. That means the blood leaves the heart. The blood leaves the heart. This is the heart part. That is four chambers. When fresh blood leaves left ventricle and enters into the body, it left the heart. That is, this is one time it left the heart. Clear? Now, in the fresh blood is in our body. When the body emits carbon dioxide rich blood, it again enters into the heart. It again enters into the heart at right atrium. That means here blood enters two times in heart. One is here, that is fresh blood from lungs enters at left atrium and again it emits the heart, and then the carbon dioxide rich blood emits the body and it enters through the right atrium. That means again in this case the blood enters the heart. That means the blood enters two times, one is here and the another one is here. So blood enters or blood passes the heart two times. That's why it is termed as double circulation. That means blood circulate two times in a heart. That's why it is termed as double circulation. Clear? So the transportation is complete. This is the most important topic among all the topics I have taught. This is complete. Transportation topics will complete, and the next topic will be your excretion. Clear? So total chapter will complete. Thank you.